Falcon Heavy, Europa Clipper mission now has a rocket ride. One of the most important things that not only scientists but people in general want to know is whether we are alone or not in the universe. We actually know very few things about life as we know it and how it originated here on Earth. Astronomers now are trying to figure out if they can find some signs of life on another planet. Also, they noticed that some moons could potentially support life as we know it. That's why the study of the moons in our solar system has become important over the last decades. One of the most promising ones is Jupiter's moon Europa. That's why NASA programmed a dedicated mission called Europa Clipper, and Europa Clipper now has a rocket ride. Keep watching the video to get to know more about what will be the main goals of the Europa Clipper mission, and how and when it will begin its journey to the Jovian moon. When we talk about life as we know it, we don't have a satisfying theory to explain how it formed. But we know for sure that it requires three things to thrive: a source of energy like sunlight, a liquid solvent like water, and elements like carbon that can form complex molecules known as organics. These are fundamental ingredients that need to be present in order for a planet, or a moon, to support life. Well, guess what? Jupiter's icy moon Europa may have all of these things. Europa is just slightly smaller than Earth's moon and is covered with a shell of ice that is roughly 20 kilometers or 12 miles thick. What's interesting about this ice shell is that beneath it lies a saltwater ocean up to 150 kilometers, 100 miles deep, with more than twice the amount of water in Earth's oceans, salty liquid water on Europa. Can you believe it? Also, Jupiter offers a potential source of energy because with its strong magnetic field, the planet traps high-energy particles from the Sun, accelerating them into Europa's ice. This, in theory, creates metabolism-driving molecules like hydrogen, ammonia, and methane. Starting from these elements, it should be clear that we need to study Europa closer. That's what NASA wants to do starting from 2024. The Europa Clipper spacecraft will launch in 2024 on a mission to determine whether Europa can support life. Its journey will take 6 years, arriving in 2030 on the Jovian moon. This will be the first dedicated mission to explore a world besides Earth with a global ocean known as an ocean world. By determining whether Europa has the right conditions for life, Europa Clipper will help us understand the prospects for life on other ocean worlds in our solar system and beyond. Including its solar panels, Europa Clipper spans 22 meters or 72 feet, longer than a basketball court. The spacecraft is packed with a wide range of science instruments to scan Europa from above and directly sample the moon's tenuous atmosphere. Of course, if we want to send this spacecraft to Jupiter, we need a rocket ride. And if you want to launch a $4.25 billion spacecraft, you want a smooth rocket ride. NASA's highly anticipated mission to Jupiter's ocean moon, Europa, now has one. Europa Clipper will launch atop a SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket. NASA officials announced Friday, on July 23rd, the total value of the contract is about $178 million, they added. As we can read on the SpaceX website, Falcon Heavy is the most powerful operational rocket in the world by a factor of two. With the ability to lift into orbit nearly 64 metric tons, Falcon Heavy can lift more than twice the payload of the next closest operational vehicle, the Delta IV Heavy. Falcon Heavy is composed of three Falcon 9 engine cores whose 27 Merlin engines together generate more than 5 million pounds of thrust at liftoff, equal to approximately 18 747 aircraft. Anyway, if all goes according to plan, and of course we hope so, Clipper will lift off in October 2024 from NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. And as programmed, it will arrive on Europa in April of 2030. What the probe will do is study Europa in depth during nearly 50 close flybys of the moon over the course of about 4 Earth years, mission team members have said. One of the most important things Clipper will do, among many other tasks, is to characterize the ocean and ice shell and hunt for some safe places to land a life-hunting Europa surface craft, which Congress has directed NASA to develop. However, for now, the lander mission remains only a concept because it is not on NASA's books yet, and mostly because it doesn't have any funding yet. The announcement made some days ago ends a lengthy launch limbo for the Europa Clipper mission. In fact, Congress originally instructed NASA to launch both Clipper and the Future Lander on the Space Launch System, SLS, the giant rocket that the agency is building to launch people and probes to deep space destinations. Unfortunately, SLS had some troubles and its development has been plagued by delays and cost overruns over the years. This is why the mega rocket still hasn't flown. However, its first few missions will be those of the famous NASA Artemis program for lunar exploration, which aims to land people on the moon as early as 2024 and establish a human presence there by the end of the decade. It has therefore been unclear when an SLS would become available for Europa Clipper. But this past January, the Europa Clipper team finally got the clarity it wanted in the form of a memo from NASA's Planetary Missions Program Office. Team members were instructed to stop planning for a possible SLS launch. Clipper would ride to space on a commercial rocket, the Elon Musk's Falcon Heavy. If you happen to visit the SpaceX website, in the Falcon Heavy section, you will see that Falcon Heavy has flown 3 times to date. By the way, if you like this video, please be sure to press the like button so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel by clicking the bell so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. After abandoning the idea of sending Clipper aboard SLS, NASA knew that Clipper's ride to Europa would have been more circuitous with a Falcon Heavy launch. In fact, SLS would have sent Clipper on a direct-to-Jupiter trajectory, arriving at the giant planet less than 3 years after liftoff. The use of a commercial rocket instead of SLS will require Clipper to perform some boosting flybys of Mars and Earth in February of 2025 and December of 2026, respectively. Mission project scientist Bob Pappalardo of NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Southern California said earlier this year. Also, Europa Clipper will arrive on Jupiter first and orbit it instead of Europa directly, spending the bulk of its time outside of the planet's intense radiation field. The spacecraft will periodically dive through Jupiter's radiation, fly by Europa for data collection, and then flee the scene. This is a smart strategy that will allow Europa Clipper to study the moon for years rather than days or months. Before finishing off the video, here are some things that the Europa Clipper mission will be capable to do. 1. A radar instrument will map Europa's ice. 2. A magnetometer will determine the depth and salinity of the ocean. 3. Color and infrared cameras will map the surface in color, searching for hotspots where the ocean may be seeping up through the ice shell. 4. Spectrometers will determine the composition of the surface and scan any plumes spouting water into space. 5. The spacecraft also has tools to directly sample Europa's atmosphere, including possible ocean water and surface particles shot into space by Jupiter's radiation. 6. It will scout locations where future space missions might land. As anticipated, one mission under consideration by NASA would spend a month on Europa's surface, feeding samples into instruments designed to detect organic materials. Last but not least, Europa Clipper will amaze us with new discoveries. We just have to wait for the launch. Are you planning to watch it live in 2024? We surely will. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. What are your thoughts about this video? Let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to share. Everyone deserves to know about the Europa Clipper mission. See you next time for another interesting video.